going to show the way that that vortex goes through there with the heat and the gas. Welcome to my latest video. On this one, I have a brief discussion about some of the stuff that I use at home and on the field. I have an aversion to plastic. I hate it, and I think it is a big problem for the planet. I'm not a tree hugger, but I want to do what I can to use reusable or sustainable products, and also to support small industry versus humongous conglomerates that dump empty bottles into the ocean to make the big Pacific garbage island that I've read about. So on this one, I want to talk to you about something from Klean Kanteen. I have Klean Kanteen. I have some of their water bottles that I use every single day. I really try and avoid plastic bottled water if I can do it. I'd rather have something right out of the tap into my stainless steel, or perhaps through like a kitchen filter or a filter you keep in the fridge, for instance, those gallon bottles. So as you can see here, I've got my Klean Kanteen cup. That's stainless steel. It's got a rolled lip on it. It's got a little bit of a logo down the bottom. You might be able to see, probably not, there's a bit of condensation on the side because this is relatively cool compared to the room, which I've got warm. So what I put on that is a reef lease coozy. These parts that I'll be showing you today is all available on Amazon. I bought all my stuff, nothing free here, no sponsors. So this is how it usually runs around the house. This can take hot or cold liquids. I don't recommend hot. Warm is fine. A cup of tea is great, but you gotta let it cool off a bit. If you put your mouth to this and it's hot enough to be painful to your lips, then you should not be drinking that tea in the first place. It should have cooled off since. So I've done hot stuff, I've done cool stuff. It's a little awkward for the hot compared to the cool, but just let it cool off a little bit so it's drinkable and it's totally doable. It's not an issue. I'm gonna put my one aside that I'm drinking from, and I'll bring my props in here. So there's the actual thing. You can see the rolled edge on that. It's got a nice bottom. This is the logo, and I'll bring you in closer for that. So that was the close-ups of the bottom and the side. I'm sorry, with my lighting in here, it's really hard to not get a glare on this cylinder. So it's indented on the inside. Once again, rolled lip, solid bottom, stainless steel. I'm not sure the gauge. It's probably 18.8, which seems to be the industry standard. But these, I hand wash them. I don't put them in the dishwasher because I don't want to get a tarnish on them if those dishwashing liquids have something in there, those polishers and shiners and stuff. They can really mark up some of the stainless products. So I try and just hand wash them. I can use one of these all day, cups of water, cups of juice, cups of milk, cup of tea. Give it a good rinse, give it a wing, and wipe it out, dry it out. You're good to go. A reasonable investment is these reef lease cozies, or coozies, whatever they want to call them. They're available in lots of different colors. I ordered from one gentleman on Amazon. He didn't have one of the colors I asked for, so he gave me two. So instead of getting two of them, he sent me three. So I've got this one here, which is, they're all reversible as well. So you can go that color. They've got this little loop here that you can put a carabiner on them and hang it from somewhere if you like. This is one color. Inside you can see is another. This is another color, and this is inside. What these are made from is reclaimed material, and I believe it's Patagonia's Common Threads Partnership. So this here on the bottom shows a little logo, and I'll take a picture of this as well. Alright, so I'm back from my picture session. So there you go. There's a few different colors of the koozies. Again, this is all purchased product. None of this was gifted to me. I bought it all off the web. Another thing you can do here. This is the Klean Kanteen, and I forget exactly what they term it as, but this slips up the cup, and you can get it all the way up. It's silicone, and what this gives you is something to hang it off of. So I could carabiner that on the outside of my pack or anything else I wanted to attach it to. It makes it quite easy to get around. When you're drinking out of it though, I find it's much better to have this down just above the koozie. So you get that on there and you've got yourself about half an inch or so, that's comfortable for lip feel. If you get it much tighter than that, you're either lipping up on the silicone, which is just one more thing to clean, or again, might be surprised by hot liquids. If your lower lip is touching this and is insulated, and this stuff doesn't get to touch you until it's in your mouth, it's a good way to get a small scalding burn. So there's another attachment, is the thingy there. The last one is their lid. This is a pretty innovative lid. I really like this lid. It's made by Klean Kanteen. This one here is hard plastic, but it's got the rubbery bits where it needs to here. And this top piece, it actually moves to give you your drinkability. So I'll show you this one here. It installs really easy, firm fit. Because of where the lip is, I don't want to put this opening right over that. So I'll put it close to me. Pop that in. It is not leak proof. They even say that on the packaging. It is, if you handle it correctly, it's very leak resistant, but it's not a leak proof container. So what you would do is move this here, move that to the side to open up your drinking port. Take your drink, put her down, close this up, and you're off to the races. You can handle that within reason. I wouldn't be dumping it upside down, but you can handle that within reason, and you shouldn't have much of a leak issue. The other neat part of this, and I'll have to show you this on a close-up, is in the center here, they've got a port for a straw. I'll show you that close-up. So here we have the close-up of the attachment for the carabiner. We have the lid, which moves one way, opens it up, or we come into the center, pop the straw in there, and you have a straw drink. And that's just through that star in the center there. I'll do that again here so you can see. It goes right in through the top. And you see the Klean Kanteen logo, company made.